Okay, guys, hello again. Have some material to present. This is deep, complicated, and you have to concentrate. It's almost as if I cannot concentrate enough to present it. But let me do a kind of summary first so that you know what it's about. There seems to be like this, that Prince was became somehow, I don't know, in lack of better words, crucified by the fractal. Okay. And yeah, but I mean, maybe it is inflationary because, yeah, I mentioned inflationary. There are fractal connections. I find connections to his death, connecting to my videos, or this. Not only that, I mean. It is from many directions, and it's like some kind of story is being told in reality. So maybe it's like this. Since Prince was so liked and his music, when he died, there were a lot of emotions, and it made an imprint into the fractal. And so when someone look at the fractal later, it will feedback, it will tell the story about why he was chosen, or like chosen and chosen. It's like he fits some kind of mold to be to represent something. That's how I feel. You know, he was supposedly bisexual, right? And he. You cannot tell, right? He seems like a normal guy, except for he's an artist, so he's very expressive. And he is artistic, right? We can agree on that, I believe. And he had a very special voice, right? So I will try to explain this. Why is it so, to me, I have to say, like, he seems to be chosen for this as some kind of crucifixion, and partly because of himself, he picked a symbol which was a mix of the, yeah, you see the symbol. Yeah, you see it, that symbol, right? And that's a mix of the male and female and something more. It has Eye of Horus in it, supposedly. It has some other symbology. Symbology, dangerous, right? And so why did he change his name to symbol? And supposedly it was because he felt like a slave. He wrote slave on his face, and they trademarked it. Amazingly, and he felt so. Prince supposedly felt this pressure of being. A first name, last name. and he came to represent that, in my opinion. And that's why he, this big cap's first name, last name, ship, you know? And when you're not a ship, you're an animal. That's what I say, at least. And an animal has no name. It is a symbol, maybe. And so he picked that symbol. And so I would say, like, he's quite early with this view, this understanding. Very early, right? And at the same time, he... So let's just repeat here again. Why do I talk about Prince? Yeah, so first of all, it's this kids movie. I will show a bit of it, and it's a song, Let's Go Crazy, as you can see, and it was created by, or sang, it was sang originally by Prince. I didn't know at the time, but I realized, but earlier I had this Prince connection with Pink Banana, and so the fractal is leading, it's pointing at Prince, look at Prince, look at the Pink Banana song, why? Because it predicts his death. Yeah. It does. So this is a video. Prince eerie death on the elevator. Okay.
Prince's close friend and music mogul L.A. Reid made an eerie revelation today on CBS This Morning.
The one thing that, you know, kind of spooked me about it all was here's a song called Let's Go Crazy.
Yeah.
And it says, don't let the elevator bring us down. One time when I was with him privately, he said, you know what the elevator is, right?
No.
I said, no, what's the elevator? He said, well, the elevator is the devil. Right? It scared me. I don't like to talk like that, but he said that. And so for me, it was like really haunting.
Prince, he died in the elevator, and this song predicts his death. And it's the same song that I got linked to. And we are each other's, you know, we are connected, as you can see. How did this guy, okay, I don't remember the name right now, but he sent me a link of this post place, maybe something like that. How did he know? I mean, it is something more. We are deeply connected people. People are. And if I would be less humble, I would say you are not real. You're just in my imagination. I am a brain in a jar, and you are just my illusions. But you know, what's the alternative? The alternative is that we are a brain in a jar. Basically the same thing. What's the difference? It's the same thing. Actually, it is. Like, I am a brain in a jar, or the more humble, which is like, we are a brain in a jar. Same thing. Okay, so this predicts... this connects to it because it has... This song also has the Last Supper in it, which it was for Jesus, you know, the Last Supper. It Sorry, I have some issues here. It shows the Last Supper in this Let's Go Crazy songs that Prince did. You know, let's go crazy. What is that? It is let's go lunatic, right? Let's go lunatic. Let's go crazy. So, are we gonna let the elevator bring us down? You see? And this is how he died. He died in an elevator, but it's more than that. Let's go crazy. So we have the purple banana. We have this one, the purple banana that Detroit Fractal pointing at. Yeah, I can see it now. You little Detroit fractal thing. I see it. So what's the point, right? Couldn't you just tell me with normal words? Probably not. Because when you have a 4D thing or something like that, speaking to lower dimension or something. I mean, we live in the 3D. So you cannot speak properly. It's like if we were to talk to something in even lower dimensions, that would be to do like morse, like tut 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 tut, like yeah, I cannot communicate like that. So maybe it is riddles to communicate, right? Riddles everywhere. So, yeah, it's a kids movie. And so they sing about this and then when I search for this prince, I find it's monkey symbology. And of course the monkey thing started with in the special community, you know, between men and men, you know. And who knows, right? Who cares? I don't care actually about where it started. I'm just summarizing the patterns, right? Yeah, I better live now before the Grim Reaper. So, yeah, basically, quite obvious, he thinks about the elevator, bringing it down, the Grim Reaper, purple banana, and what my little comment is, you're not seeing me here because I'm sitting in my underwear, to be honest, it's quite hot here, what's this? What does it say? I didn't know. Wait.
Guys, watch.
What kills me?
Not if I kill you first.
Oh, whatever. No, not related.
Serious, guys.
So, yeah. In a way, he seems to represent this crucifixion. The joinment of male and female. Maybe. And, yeah. And to be honest, all of this fractal could just be propaganda also from an evil force. And that's actually my point of view. It is. And but there's also truth in it in some way. And I rather find out again and again and again that I'm wrong than to follow something and assume something to be all-knowing and so on. And give up control, right? You understand that, right? Okay, so basically, I think this is it. And is it going to be something more about Prince? Isn't it quite clear at this time why it started in that community? Or the focus was there, at least. Yeah, I do believe that it's not going to be that. This certain community between men, it's also a way to strategically avoid exposure. I believe it's working in the background, and maybe things are happening, right? We had the one thing that was the solar corona stuff, and we have the moon thing now. So we had the sun, and now it's the moon. The sun, it was really important to describe it as scary as possible, as early as possible. And that's also the elevator thing. Elevator contains L. L means God and the sun, actually, in my opinion. And elevator taking you down, right? I don't know, but what was I saying? Yeah, it doesn't have to be in that community. It's just maybe something to create some cognitive dissonance and this political correct denial behavior, right? And avoidance and not, I don't see this because I cannot talk about it because it's in a certain community, right? So they cannot see it. So the thing is, I do believe that there is something in this community, in this LGBT community, which is sick. Okay. There's also probably some part that is healthy, right? There is some. I explained in some video that there actually is some point in some logical explanations for this to exist that I showed in one video. But there is also a sickness in this. And this sickness relates to the shadow mind. And probably that's why it's showing itself there. Also, besides from being a way to not create a debate, not create attention, because they cannot talk about it. It's too loaded subject. And so normies, right? Some people call them NPCs. Why? Because they have no soul, maybe you think. But what is that? Yeah, we called the soul an anima, and the anima was in the shadow mind. There is something about this NPC, this normie, that it is immature in its shadow mind, and it a human consists of the good and the bad, and if the bad cannot express itself, you know what? It's going to do it anyways, but it's going to take control, and it's not going to be understood. And this is why some people consider, or yeah, many people consider this normie behavior to have this this subtle evil in it, which is hard to explain. Basically, yeah, there is some immature, there's something sick in this shadow mind in that community, the other one, but there is also something lacking in it, in the normies. So we have it in both of them. And that's also the yeah, let's just end this video here. And I think I believe, I think that I understand now why it started to show things about this purple banana. And I sound crazy, right? I talk about the Muppet Show, I talk about some kids or movie. And but you see here, it predicts the death of Prince. So it's fine, right?
Song called Let's Go Crazy.
Yeah.
And it says, "Don't let the elevator bring us down."
So let's end it there. Have a good day, I guess. Bye bye.